Hello everybody, and welcome to another session of this online course, English One, a course that is part of the program Vamos para la Universidad, led by Universidad de Antioquia. I send special greetings to all teachers and students who are participating in this program, and I hope that you have learned a lot so far, that you have enjoyed all these sessions, all these classes, and that you have learned, that you have improved in your learning process. Okay, we are going to have an important session this week that is belongs to Unit 1, Week 4, Session 1. Why is this class or these two classes important? Because we are like having a compilation of the whole unit to demonstrate what we have learned so far. All right? So here are the goals, the objectives for this week. Initially, we are going to demonstrate our capacity to describe habits and routines, yes, in our everyday lives. Yes. Then we are also going to make contrast between actions to express habits and actions to express movement, progress in at the moment of speaking. It means making a contrast between what we studied in the previous week and the ones that we are going to study this week, all right? And finally, one of the most important things to do this week is that we are going to elaborate our first creative activity, yes, in which you are going to demonstrate how much English you have learned, all right? Very important things to do this week. All right. Are you all ready for this session? Ready to go? Let me check here who is online right now. Okay. Is everything, are you listening to me? Am I speaking very clearly? All right. Great. So here we go. We are going to begin with this introductory activity. Okay. Look at this picture. Yes. And talk to a classmate. What do you see in the picture? Okay? In couples, two students, talk about what you see in the picture. All right. Very good. Here people are participating. They are at the gym. Great. There are two people. Excellent. What are they doing? They are doing spinning. Yes, that's great. Okay. Yes. They are at the gym. They are exercising. Very good. All right. Good. Excellent that you identified the place. Let's go to the second one. Well, it's the same picture. The same place, but pay attention. Remember, you are speaking to one student, two students. First, who is in the picture? Make these questions to each other. Where are they? What is she? What is she doing? And then you respond these personal questions. Do you exercise? How often do you exercise, and where do you exercise? I'm going to repeat the instruction. First, respond these three questions that are connected with the picture. And second, respond these personal questions. These questions are for you, okay? I'm going to repeat the questions. Who is in the picture? Where are they? What is she doing? It means the woman. And then these personal questions. Do you exercise? How often do you exercise? Where do you exercise? I'm going to give you 1 minute to do that. Let me check here. Very good. Let's see. Okay, here we have some answers so far. They are in the gym. Very good. Who is in the picture? There are 2 men and 1 woman. Are you sure? Very good. There are 4 people. 1, 2, 3, and 4. They are exercising. Very good. Okay. What about she? What is she doing? She's spinning. Great. Excellent. How about this guy here? What is he doing? Yes, it's another option. They are cycling. Very good. He's jumping. Yes, he's jumping rope. Excellent. All right. Very nice. Now we have... Now, answer these questions. Do you exercise? Yes or no? Yes, I do. No, I don't. Or are you Coach Potatoes? You exercise. Excellent. And I suppose that exercising in the countryside is excellent. Surrounded by mountains, by animals, things like that is excellent. Okay. How often do you exercise? How frequently do you exercise? Never. Twice a week. Very good. Very rarely. From Monday to Friday. Oh, that's pretty much. Every day, oh my God. They do it 3 times a week. No, the question is about you. You, how often do you exercise? Every day. Oh, so we have here a lot of sports people. All right, 2 times a week. Are you exercise at the park? Excellent. Good. So you exercise at the park, at the gym. What about at home? Do you exercise at home? Yes or no? Yes. That was a funny answer. Typing on the cell phone. That is exercising for you. For your fingers. Excellent. All right. Good. This is like the previewing activity. So we are going to do, well, that's the preparation for the activity that we are going to do. All right. We are going to observe a video, to watch a video. Okay. And you, yes, you are going to take notes in your notebooks about the information that you identify in the video. Yes, pay attention to how They describe the habits, their routines, their activities that they do in their everyday lives. Okay. I repeat the instruction. You are going to watch the video. Yes. You are going to take notes on your notebooks. Yes. About how they describe the activities in the video, the activities that they do every day. Is the instruction clear? Yes. Yes. All right, only two institutions say yes. Do I have to repeat instruction? Okay, no, it's all right. Okay, I'm going to play the video, and remember, take notes of the information that you find in the video, how they talk about their everyday lives. Here we go.
Hello, how are you?
Hey, I'm great. How are you doing?
I'm great.
Do you train here?
Yes, I come here to lift weights. What about you?
Well, I come to spinning sessions. How many times a week do you come to the gym?
I come here 3 times a week. And where do you live?
I live in front of the park library.
Oh, I have a new motorcycle. Do you want to ride home?
Oh, thanks, but my boyfriend takes me home every day in his car.
Okay. See you later.
Bye.
All right. Did you take notes of the information on the video? Okay, I'm going to repeat the video. Again, I'm going to repeat the video, and remember, take notes of the information that they mention in the video about their everyday lives and other information that they say. Okay, I'm going to repeat the video.
Hello, how are you?
Hey, I'm great. How are you doing?
I'm great.
Do you train here?
Yes, I come here to lift weights. What about you?
Well, I come to spinning sessions. How many times a week do you come to the gym?
I come here 3 times a week. And where do you live?
I live in front of the park library.
Oh, I have a new motorcycle. Do you want to ride home?
Oh, thanks, but my boyfriend takes me home every day in his car.
Okay. See you later.
Bye.
All right. Are you ready now? So you took notes on your notebooks. Okay. Now, two classmates, yes, you are going to compare, yes, the information that you got from the video. Okay? Make a comparison of the information. Cars kill more. These people are fun. Okay. Okay, now tell me, based on the video, tell me the information that you got from the video. Very good. He lifts weights. Very good. How often does he exercise? Twice a week? Is that correct? Twice or three times? Okay, three times a week. Three times a week, that's correct. Now, she has spinning classes, all right? What other information did you get from the video? Very good. He has a new motorcycle. Excellent. Motorcycle, sorry. He has a new motorcycle, yes. Very good. What other information? Where does she live? Ah, that is another important part. Her boyfriend. Has a car. And I read something funny here. They say car kills motorcycle. Very good. He picks her up. Very good. How often does her boyfriend pick her up? How often? How frequently? Yes, her boyfriend picks her up. Yes, but how often? She doesn't like poor boys. That's a good one. How often in the video they mention how often her boyfriend picks her up? How frequently? You have an answer. I need the answer. You say her boyfriend has a car. He picks her up. How often? Very good. They say every day. Very good. Every day. Every day. Yes. That's nice. And you mentioned a car kills a motorcycle. Very good. And she doesn't like poor boys. That's fun. Good. Excellent. Great job. All right. Remember, I'm going to remind you something. Remember that if you need extra information about the topic that we are studying this week, you check your mochilas, yes, and here you are going to find special information about the present simple. This tense is used to express routines and habits. Okay, so you find information about how to elaborate affirmative sentences, negative sentences, and interrogative sentences. All right, yes. So now, let's go to our first understanding or comprehension activity, okay? Initially, we are going to check, yes, some vocabulary, all right? I need to check some vocabulary. Here we have some words, and we are going to complement these words because these words are going to appear in your activity of comprehension. Do you know the meaning of arrive. Give me a synonym of arrive. Very good. Llegar. I'm gonna write the synonyms here. Give me 1 second. Arrive, a synonym, get, another synonym. Excellent. Come. Very nice. Now, do is okay? Yes or no? Very good. Hacer. A synonym of do. Make. Very good. Excellent. Now, eat. No problem. Yes or no? Comer. Very good. Excellent. Good. Now the next one. Get dressed. Vestirse. Excellent. How can we express the same? Get dressed. Give me another option. Excellent. Very good, San Jose. You say put, yes, for example, my, excuse me. I'm going to raise here. Put on my clothes. Excellent. No, how do you say the desvestirse, the opposite? This is, yes, get dressed is a synonym of put on my clothes. And how do you say, very good. Get undressed. And a synonym. No. No, San Jose, no, it's put off. Put off, pay attention, put off is a synonym of postpone. Okay? All right. Very good, this one, San Jose, yes. Take off. Okay, take off my clothes. Excellent. Yes, that is a very good synonym. Now, we have here go. What is go? Very common action. Ir, very good. Have. Tener, very good. Leave. Okay, dejar. Salir. Okay, we are going to use it here in this context as salir. Very good. Leave. We are here. Salir. All right. Estamos en este. Leave. All right. Now, this one, play. Okay, pay attention. We are going to use this verb here, leave. Yes, as a synonym of get out of a place. Okay. We are going to use leave in this context because in another context, for example, leave can be a synonym of abandon, for example. But in this context of this that we are expressing, describing routines, we are going to use this as a synonym of leave out, excuse me, get out of a place. All right. Yes. Remember that we are describing routines or habits. Now, study. Very good. Excuse me. How do you say in English, hacer tareas? Do homework or make homework? Excellent. Do homework. This is very important because we mentioned before that do and make are synonyms, but not always. We can use do or exchange. For example, we cannot say in English make homework, right? Yes, that is another example, San Jose. You can do the dishes, for example, but you cannot make the dishes. You can make the bed, excellent example, but you cannot do the bed. Excellent examples. Very good. All right, this is important that you keep in mind. Now, talk. What's the meaning of talk? Well, a synonym, speak, hablar, conversar, very good. Visit, no problem, very similar to Spanish. Now, this verb, wake up. Very good. Now, what is the difference between wake up and get up? What's the difference? Despertarse y levantarse. Very good. Yes, very good, San Jose. When you wake up, you just open your eyes. Very good. And when you get up, it's like that you stand up from your bed. Okay. Very good. Excellent. You are so prepared for this class. Excellent. Excellent, San Jose. You are very good. All right. Wash. Lavar o lavarse. Very good. And watch. Ver o mirar. Very good. Now that we have explored this vocabulary, you are going to log in your platforms, yes, your virtual courses. You are going to enter this activity. What's his daily routine? Click on this activity. Are you following me? Go to your virtual courses in the platform and enter this. Click on this topic. What's his daily routine? Did you find it? ¿Lo encontraron? Remember, week 4, semana 4. Estamos en semana 4. Yes, week 4. And you look for one activity that is called What's His Daily Routine? Look at this activity on the list. All right. Let's see something here. Okay. Good. When you open the activity, you are going to find a list of verbs, of actions, and you have here pictures representing those actions. Yes, like some pictures describing Juan's routine. All right. Okay. Next, you click and you are going to find a text. Yes. that you have to complete selecting. Yes, you click here and you select the corresponding action, the corresponding form, the correct form. Okay. So can you complete the text, and then we are going to compare the answers. Is the instruction clear? Remember, watch the pictures. And we have already explored the actions, okay? So that's not the problem. Now you have the pictures and you are going to complete the text, yes, according to the pictures, the routines that are described about Juan. Again, I'm going to tell you, San José, van a buscar en la semana 4, recuerde que estamos unidad 1, semana 4, unit 1, week 4, ok, y en esa lista de actividades que tenemos ahí, van a buscar una que voy a recordarles el título, que se llama así, se llama What's His Daily Routine. Ok, este es el título. Búsquenla ahí en la lista de las actividades que hay para realizar en la semana. ¿La encontraron? Ya cuando le dan clic, les va a aparecer esta imagen. Una lista de verbos que ya los miramos. Y les aparece esta imagen con la rutina de Juan. So far so good. Hasta ahí vamos bien. All right. Okay. So now your first activity is that you have to complete the text. Yes, San José, estamos en la plataforma, les dije entrar, lo que pasa es que en este momento no me da la posibilidad de compartir la pantalla, ok, entonces búsquenlo en su plataforma, en el curso virtual, sí, exactly, week, unit 1, week 4, unidad 1, semana 4. Ahí está la lista de las actividades que estamos haciendo esta semana. Entonces busquen la que se titula What's His Daily Routine. Okay. Great, great. Exactly. Now go on the exercise that is completing the text. I'm going to give you like 2 minutes. It's okay. The text is after the pictures. You have these pictures. And look at the text here. Miren el texto ahí debajo. Debajo de las imágenes. Ese es el texto. Let's do it together, all right? So the other people that haven't had access to the platform can do the exercise. Remember that is your responsibility to do the activities in the platform. All right. We are going to complete the text together. I'm going to read the ideas and you are going to tell me how do you complete the information. Yes, thank you for the observation, Marco Emilio. Yes, that's correct. I'm going to start reading the text, okay? And you tell me the correct form of the verb. On school days, Juan wakes up at 6:30. He washes his face and what is the next word? He washes his face and very good, Marco Emilio. Here you say get dressed. Very good. Dressed. At 7:30, I'm going to continue. At 7:30, he. Very good. San Jose has breakfast. All right. I'm going to continue. He usually eats. Very good. He usually eats arepa, eggs, and chocolate. So far, so good. Vamos bien hasta ahí. All right. Good. Now let's continue. He, the next part after chocolate, he leaves. Very good, San Jose. He leaves. And por aquí Marco Emilio ya me había hecho la observación de que está repetido, ok. So he leaves home at 8:15 or a quarter past 8. Remember the time. And what is the next option? Arrives. Very good. Arrives to school. No, arrives no. Excuse me. That's not arrives. Goes. Very good. Goes to school. Enseguida vamos a hacer una diferenciación ahí en estos verbos. Ok. So, and goes to school by bike. Hasta ahí vamos bien. So far, so good. All right. Now, he usually arrives, ahora sí, he usually arrives at school at a quarter to 9. Okay. Now, this part, he has, very good San Jose, he has lessons until lunchtime. Lunchtime at school is from 12:30 to 1, you can see here, to 1:30 in the afternoon. He has, again, very good, Warner Lozano. He has more lessons. Or plays, very good here. He plays basketball. Okay. He normally arrives home, very good, at four. He and his parents have dinner, very good. Have dinner at 8. In the evenings, Luis does, very good. Wagner Lozano, very good. La Agricola de Tamesis, very good. He does his homework, okay? The next one, watches TV, very good. Or, yes, watches TV. Or, what is the last one? Visits, very good. Visits his friends. Very good. They talk, very good. They talk about their plans for the weekend. All right, great job. Now, you are going to do the second exercise. If you continue, si continúan más abajito, you are going to find these questions, comprehension questions. Respond the questions. Yes, and then we compare the answers. These questions. All right. I'm going to give you a couple of minutes to respond the questions.
¿Será que estaba funcionando el video ahí todavía? No. Ok.
Let's compare the answers because the text is very simple for you. Now you have the example here. What time does Juan wake up?
Mira. De acá. Cierto. Ahí está.
Okay. Sorry. Again, question number one is the example. What time does Juan wake up? And the answer is he wakes up at 6:30. Question number two, does he have a shower in the morning? No, he doesn't. Very good. No, he doesn't. Ah, como cochinito, ¿cierto? No, he doesn't. Number three, what does he usually have for breakfast? Question number three, I repeat the question. What does he usually have for breakfast? Very good. He usually has arepa, eggs, and chocolate. Very good. Number four, question number four. How does he go to school? Yes, very good. It's, pay attention. This is very important. Stop for a while. Paren un momentico aquí. En cuando estemos haciendo este tipo de preguntas de información, si yo respondo, por ejemplo, what does he usually have for breakfast? Y yo respondo arepa, eggs and chocolate. Bueno, está bien, la respuesta está correcta. Pero la recomendación es de que ustedes elaboren la idea completa. ¿Para qué? Para que se familiaricen más con la estructura de las frases. ¿Cómo estructuro yo una idea completa? Y así la, digamos, asimilo. ¿Cómo puedo hablar yo de mis rutinas? Listo, es una recomendación. Es como ustedes allá en la clase, ustedes profesores les preguntan a sus estudiantes, what's your favorite color? Y si yo digo blue, está correcto, ¿cierto? Pero ¿qué me da a mí más fluidez para hablar y tener aquí, digamos, la estructura de las frases? Que yo responda, my favorite color is blue. Ok. Entonces, esa es la idea, para que podamos asimilar toda la estructura como tal de cómo expresar, en este caso, los hábitos o las rutinas. Alright. So, question number four. How does he go to school? So, he goes to school by bike. Very good. All right, he goes to school by bike. Now, how long does the journey take? The right answer, it takes... No, that's incorrect. How long? It means the period of time. ¿Cuánto tiempo? A ver, miren el texto. Yes, in minutes, pero ¿cuántos? How long? Yes, in minutes. ¿Cuántos serían minutos? ¿O en horas? No, ahí mencionan en el texto. Estamos hablando de the journey that he takes to go to school. Journey es viaje, como el viaje. No es 4 horas, no. I'm going to repeat the question in Spanish. ¿Como cuánto tiempo le toma para llegar allá? 15 minutes? No, I'm going to go back to the text. Vamos a ver. Dice por acá. Recuerden en el texto, dice, he leaves home at 8:15. Sale de la casa a las 8:15. And goes to school by bike. He usually arrives at school at 8:45. Very good, San Jose. Yes, it takes about half an hour, 30 minutes. 30 minutes, okay? The answer is 30 minutes. Very good. All right, it's only half an hour. Now, number six. Where does he have lunch? Complete answer. Quiero la respuesta completa. Completa. Complete idea. Very good, San Jose. He has lunch at school. Great job. Now, number seven. What does he do in the afternoons? In the afternoons, no? What does he do in the afternoons? He plays what? He plays basketball, very good. Or another option, because two options. He plays basketball or remember, according to the text. Yes, I'm going to give you time, no problem. Check the text. I repeat the question. What does he do in the afternoons? No, that's not correct. I'm going to return to the text again and we check. Vamos a chequear aquí donde dice, in the afternoons he has more lessons or plays basketball. Si están viendo, the activities that he does, he has more lessons or plays basketball. Very good. Number eight. Question number eight. When do Juan and his parents have dinner? All right. Question number eight. When do Juan and his parents have dinner? They have dinner exactly what time? Nowhere is when. When do Juan and his parents have dinner? Very good, San Jose. They have dinner at 8 p.m. Very good. Number nine. What does he do after dinner? He watches TV. What else? Two more options. He watches TV. He has three activities after dinner. Watches TV. What else? Yes, Gaspar de Rodas, very good. He watches TV. What the other two activities? According to the text, he does his homework, very good. Or the third activity. So he does homework, he watches TV, or well, visits his friends. And question number 10. What does he do with his friends? He talks with his friends. Very good. Yes, they talk about the weekend, about their plans for the weekend. All right. Congratulations. Now, I'm going to explain the guided activity. Voy a explicar la actividad guiada y ustedes se quedan ahí realizando la actividad y van a esperar un momento que van a tener a alguien más aquí. Listo. Explico la actividad. Es una actividad oral, de práctica oral. ¿Cierto? La actividad se llama My Daily Routine. Ahí está en su plataforma, en el curso virtual. ¿En qué consiste? Trabajan en parejas y aquí tienen cuatro preguntas que se van a hacer entre ustedes. Y ustedes, si quieren, deciden ahí en las parejas hacer otras tres preguntas o las pueden hacer en general en la clase. Otras tres, para que la entrevista tenga por lo menos siete preguntas con relación a sus rutinas que hacen en la mañana, en la tarde, en la noche. ¿Está bien? ¿Está clara la instrucción? Muy bien, eso es para que lo hagan ahí de forma oral. Y ahí complementan el vocabulario, qué actividades hay en la mañana, qué actividades normalmente hacemos en la tarde y en la noche. ¿Está bien? So, thank you for your participation today. If you noticed, today I used more English. So, that's the idea that every class we are going to include much more English in our lessons. And I noticed that today you participated very much, all right? That was great. Thank you for your job, for your participation, and see you next session, all right?